Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerVIP.com. Look us up in the sports section on Roku. We're there, Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. On iTunes, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, knockouts cause amnesia. Young guys, untested guys, tend to be the most overrated in the sport. Now, the odds are posted on oddschecker.com for the upcoming bout between Kevin Johnson, who went the distance with Vitaly Klitschko, who went the distance with Tyson Fury, who went the distance with Derek Chisora, who went the distance with Manuel Char. For those keeping count, he's even gone the distance with Christian Hammer, the guy Tyson Fury is set to fight next. Now, Kevin Johnson is fighting a guy whose claim to fame is that he won an Olympic gold medal. Whoop-dee-doo. But yet, somehow, according to Odds Checker, Anthony Joshua, who has never gone to the fourth round. Let me repeat that. This is low by even Gennady Golovkin standards. Anthony Joshua has never made it to the fourth round of a fight. He's young, he's green, he's had 10 fights, he has 10 knockouts. You're telling me he's a 33-1 favorite to beat Kevin Johnson in a 10-round match? You gotta be kidding me. This is a joke, right? Is this some kind of ploy by casinos, some kind of sale by casinos to lure in the innocent? These odds are preposterous. Kevin Johnson, by the way, the spread's so ridiculous, you can get 16-1 on Kevin Johnson. Now, I'm not here saying Kevin Johnson wins the fight. I'm not making that claim. But what I am saying is, these odds are so ridiculous, right? I wouldn't expect Kevin Johnson to be a 16-1 underdog against Derek Chisora, right? Keep in mind, Chisora also fought Vitaly Klitschko. Chisora also fought Tyson Fury, right? These are real experienced heavyweights. But yet, you're telling me Johnson's a 16-1 underdog against Anthony Joshua? The bet I'm recommending here is to take the 16-1 odds. Kevin Johnson to win the fight, hedged with Joshua by KO. Maybe Joshua gets the KO. I don't know. But understand, Joshua is going to be in new territory when he enters the fourth round of the fight. Right? Understand, there's a whole second half of the fight after the fifth round. It's going to be new for Joshua. Now, I know Kevin Johnson's been losing fights. There's no question about that. I'm guessing the bloom is off the rose for Kevin Johnson. But let's get real here. Kevin Johnson has never, let me repeat that, he has never been knocked out. Understand, he has gone the distance against his last three opponents, and they've been Christian Hammer, Derek Chisora, and Manuel Char. Real names. How real? Manuel Char has fought Vitaly Klitschko. Christian Hammer is about to fight Tyson Fury. Right? These are guys who have been on the top rung of the heavyweight division. These aren't newbie guys fresh off an amateur background. That's what the Olympics is, folks. That's the amateur part of the sport. These aren't some guys given some shiny medal who now have gotten knockouts at the beginning of their career, who are just now wading into the deep part of the pool. What is Anthony Joshua going to bring to the table that Vitaly Klitschko didn't bring against Kevin Johnson? Does anyone know? Understand, Kevin Johnson's a guy who KO'd Alex Lippe. Right? Think about it. Right? What is Anthony Joshua going to bring in the ring that Alex Lippe didn't bring? So, I just think the public hype has gotten way out of control. Do you really believe that if these guys fought 99 times, that this Green Anthony Joshua would win 96 of the 99 times? That's what a 33-1 odd implies. Right? It's ridiculous. It's simply ridiculous. So, put me among those who is gonna challenge the casino here. Right? 16-1 odds on a guy who's actually fought and gone the distance with Vitaly Klitschko. Sign me up. I like Kevin Johnson at 16-1, hedged with Joshua by KO. If Joshua comes out and does what Joshua does, destroys you in the first three rounds of a fight, right? Pretends he's Deontay Wilder, another guy who I think is unproven, right? If he's able to take you out like he does, okay, great, you live for another day, right? You've hedged the play. But if he comes out and suddenly realizes that experience matters in the sport of boxing, that Kevin Johnson has actually faced more top-rung guys than he has. Right? That Kevin Johnson has faced guys who have contended for the heavyweight title. Right? If he finds out that Kevin Johnson actually has defense and that's why he was able to survive against guys like Derek Chisora, Vitaly Klitschko, Manuel Char, Tyson Fury. If he figures that out and he's suddenly in the deep end of the pool and we get to places in a fight he hasn't been, seventh round, eighth round, ninth round, if Johnson conserves his energy so that he has something left in the tank, the last few rounds of this fight against a young guy who has to be doubting himself late in the fight. Right? If he doesn't knock out, take out Johnson, who's never been stopped, then it's going to get interesting. With odds like this, I truly believe the bet makes itself. 16-1 on Kevin Johnson, I'll take it. Hedged with Anthony Joshua by KO. Let me hear from you. By the way, let me correct the statement I made before. I talked about Joshua winning 96 out of 99 fights, according to these odds. It's even more preposterous than that. According to these odds, Joshua would win 33 fights for every one that Johnson wins. So Joshua would win 99 fights when Johnson wins three fights. In other words, 33-1 implies that Johnson would win three out of 102 fights between these two. I'm not buying the hype. I like the underdog here, hedged with the favorite by KO. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.